Hello and welcome back. And this is adjusting our entries part 7. And this is where we're going to take the rest of the question that we've just done and work through the final elements. So this is my disclaimer and copyright notice. The information and opinions of this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2019 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. I encourage you to share this presentation and share links to this presentation on an unmodified basis. If you do modify the presentation in any way, please email me prior to doing so at 1812cpa@gmail.com to discuss. Note, the author does not claim any copyright whatsoever in any companies or organizations a list mentioned in this presentation or the other parties. Rather, the other parties are the owners of their respective copyrights. So we're looking at this comprehensive problem, and now we're at the last part. So the earlier video, we posted the raw transactions and the T accounts. We made an unadjusted trial balance. We did the adjusting journal entries. We prepared the adjusted trial balance. And now we're going to do the income statement, statement of retained earnings, closing out the temporary accounts to retained earnings, post-closing trial balance. And then lastly, we're going to do a classified balance sheet. Okay. So right here, we're back with our adjusted trial balance. And we're gonna start over here with the first thing we're being asked to do is an income statement. So we have IEI, and we're gonna say income statement for the period ending 12/31. For the period ending 12/31/18. You have to use this type of language, very, very important. So here are my revenues. Here I've got my services revenue. My services revenue here was $70,000, or you can just call it revenue. Here you have interest revenue of $100. So my total revenues are going to be $70,100 less my expenses. So here I've got consulting services expense, I have depreciation, I have insurance expense, and then I have interest expense. So my consulting services was $10,000. My depreciation, insurance, and interest. So here are my total expenses are going to be $56,000, giving me net income of $70,100 minus 56, or $14,100. The next statement I will be required to make is going to be my statement of retained earnings. And again, I've done these on prior videos. I want to encourage you to watch them if you want it to slow down, or you can slow me down, I'm sure, by going slow motion. So here, this is my statement of retained earnings for the period or for the year ended December 31st, 2018. When I do my statement of retained earnings, I have my beginning retained earnings, which is going to be zero. Why is it zero? Because this is the first part I'm starting up. For the first year I'm starting up. Then I'm gonna add in my net income. Where does my net income come from? It comes from right up here. This is why I have to go through and do this part of the question first. So my net income is, that's why I always do the income statement first. And that's where this is coming from. Less my dividends. My dividends for this company were $4,000. Gives me my ending retained earnings of $10,100. Okay. So I've done this part here. I have prepared the statement of retained earnings. Now, for those of you at home who do not have me as an accounting instructor, what I'm about to do may cause serious trauma or I don't know. I mean, a lot of people use something called income summary. What I use are T accounts that go through and close out transactions where I'm closing out everything to retain earnings. So I know that my ending retained earnings balance here has to be 10,100. So now what I'm going to do is I need to close out all the revenue and expense accounts plus the dividends to make sure that my ending retained earnings balance gives me 10,100. So I'm going to pause real quick. We'll be back in a second. Okay, and so we're back. So on my exam, you would get something that looks like this. You're going to have a big account here labeled retained earnings, and then you're going to have all these little T accounts. So what do we do? What we're going to do is we're going to call forth Lazarus and do some accounting fun stuff. So here we're going to have revenues. And all I'm doing here is I'm essentially writing out all the temporary account balances. Interest revenue is 100. Where am I getting this from? I'm getting this from my income statement right here. I have to close out these accounts. These accounts are telling us what we earn for a particular period of time. So here I have consulting services expense, 10,000. I have insurance expense of 24,000. I have depreciation expense, 20,000. And then over here, I've got interest expense of 2,000. And then lastly, I have my dividends of 4,000. So my goal at this point in time, and the reason why I'm going over this is that some of my students have had challenges with this on the first exam, is I need to make each one of these accounts zero. And I also need to make sure that this ending balance and retained earnings is a positive $10,100. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to essentially here for my revenues to make this account zero, and I'll note this with a different color, is I need to credit this for 70,000. Excuse me, I need to debit revenues for 70,000. Why? Because that's what makes this account zero. 70,000, the $70,000 credit was my initial balance. So here for every debit, I need a credit here to retain earnings. And I know this may look simple when you're going through and watching it on the video, but I really want to encourage you to really practice. And the reason being is that when it comes to the actual exam, most students, if you haven't practiced this part, it's just going to be brutal. So over here, for my interest revenue, I also add over here a credit for 100. I need to debit interest revenue for 100 to make this zero. For every debit, I need a credit. And I'm gonna do that right over here. Then I come down over here to consulting services expense. To make these expenses zero, what I will need to do here is to make all these different accounts here debits. And I will do that in blue. So right over here. By the way, do you need to actually do things in blue or in red? No, you do not. I'm just using this. I know I had a few students on my last test who did that. It was pretty awesome. But don't write in red again. Okay, so right over here, consulting services expense. I need to credit this account by 10,000 to make it zero. For every credit, I need a debit. So over here, I'm going to debit my retained earnings. My insurance expense to make this account zero, I need a, basically need a credit. So here, I'm going to debit retained earnings. For my depreciation expense, I need to go over here to make that account zero, I need to credit the depreciation expense, and I'm going to here and debit this here. For my interest expense, to make it zero, I need to credit interest expense, and then I need to debit my interest revenue. And then here for dividends, to make this account zero, I need a credit here for 4,000. And then So right over here, I total up all of my debits and all of my credits. So I have here total credits, or excuse me, total debits of 60,000. Total credits of 70,100. I subtract the smaller value from the larger value, and I put the remainder with on the larger value side. And notice here, I get an ending balance of 10,100. Is this correct? Yes. Retained earnings, as it is part of owner's equity, has a credit balance. Why? It's the AELOE. The OE is on the DC, the credit side. So that's going to typically have a credit balance. So that's why I know that this is correct. Okay, we'll be back in a second, and we're going to prepare the post-closing trial balance. Okay, the only difference between the adjusted trial balance and then the post-closing trial balance is right here, is actually there's going to be, with terms of cash, in terms of my assets, my liabilities, these all remain the same as my adjusted balance. However, now, since I closed out my temporary accounts to retain earnings, this is now going to have a $10,100 balance as a credit, because that's what I closed out everything to. So here, my dividends, my revenue, my interest revenue, my consulting services expense, my depreciation expense, my insurance expense, and the like, all of these have now closed out to zero. So when I go through and do this part here, I now have my ending balances here at $341,100. So really important, the kind of the way that I go through and do this is I start with the unadjusted, which has no adjusting journal entries. Before I make the financial statements, I have to go through and first do the adjusted trial balance. What I use that adjusted trial balance to prepare my financial statements, or my first two, which are my income statement and my statement of retained earnings. My last step in terms of doing this is going to be my post-closing, where I've closed out all of my temporary accounts to retain earnings. My next stop, or my last stop on this tour, is to do a balance sheet. However, this time we're going to be preparing a different type of balance sheet. It is the balance sheet of Edward Snowden, or what we call the classified balance sheet. So here I'm going to have IEI balance sheet as of 12/31/18. Very important for the headings. So here I'm going to have my assets. And when I list out my assets, I'm now going to be doing these by current. And then we'll get to the next designation second. So here, current, cash, prepaid insurance, accounts receivable. Cash is 169. Prepaid insurance is 12, accounts receivable is 40. So my total assets, good job, Tchaikovsky. My total current assets will be 221,000. Now, at this point in time, if you saw my other video, what a company like Facebook did is they just dumped out everything else. So what we're going to do here, though, is I'm going to call this non-current assets. But if you just listed these out beneath, it's not necessarily going to be wrong, but there is one thing that I do want you to do. So here I've got loans receivable, interest receivable, and probably the most important part in terms of classification, and I'm going to make this a little bit different here, is that when we go through and we show property, plant, and equipment, I want you to follow a very specific format. So here, we're gonna have equipment, and this is gonna be at 100,000. I just did it in the wrong place. So my equipment's here is gonna be at 100,000. However, this accumulated depreciation amount is what we call a contra asset account, and it's going to reduce the carrying value of that equipment. So we're going to say here, less accumulated depreciation equipment is going to be giving me, so that is a negative amount, is going to be giving me equipment net. My equipment net is going to be $80,000. And the reason why you want to, and you could probably, I think it was actually not even equipment, I think it was machinery, but potato, potato, you know what I'm talking about. So even right here, this part right here, you need to show this designation, at least on my exam, because we're showing, we have to show our equipment here net of the accumulated depreciation. We've used it, and as we've used it, this balance is going to build up. If you have questions about this, please see my prior video. So here my total non-current assets are going to be 20 plus 1 plus 80. And we'll just add some more over here. Hold on. Wow, I've officially run out of room. Hold on. Okay, we're back. So my total assets are going to be 221 plus 100,100. Do you need to separate all these out? The answer is no. Why am I doing it? Just so it's easier for you to see where the numbers are coming from. Okay. Next one over here is going to be my liabilities. My current liabilities are those that are going to be payable within a year. Accounts payable, my loans payable, my interest payable, those are all current because the loan has to be repaid in the year. So my total current liabilities, good job on that spelling. Wow, geez, Tchaikovsky. So my total current liabilities here are going to be, I've got accounts payable over here of 9, loans payable of 100, interest payable of 2. So my total current liabilities are going to be, my total liabilities are going to be 111,000. Note here that I'm not listing out the unearned revenue at this point. I don't think you really have to. You can show it if you want to. It's not going to be incorrect. However, if the balance is 0, we're not going to show it unless there's a prior year amount that actually has money in it. So my owner's equity. So here for my owner's equity, I had common stock. Then I had retained earnings. My common stock was 200. My retained earnings was 10,100. So my total owner's equity is going to be 210,100. I'm not done. I now have to show my total liabilities plus owner's equity, or you can say and owner's equity. It's going to be 321,100. And so that's how I go through and balance. So the real key here is I had no liabilities that were to be settled beyond a year. They were all current because that's when the loan was due. I'm not being repaid the money for a year beyond the balance sheet date. Remember, what current versus non-current really has to do with is we're looking at the balance sheet date, and if we're going to be using it within the year, or if we have that, you know, here, this cash, this can be used within the year, or if it's long term or non-current. So with that being said, I would like to thank you for watching today and joining, and please do not forget to like and subscribe. And if you do have questions or comments, please send them to 1812cpa@gmail.com. Have a great one.